says, when I was away at school Mother's Day, Kayla, and I wasn't able to get back, but a friend of mine was going back to deliver flowers, and I said, I've written a poem. Could I ask you and give money for a flower? And so, even though I wasn't there on Mother's Day, this woman came by with a rose and this poem that my mom kept on her fridge until she was no longer with us. And this poem is called Amber Beads. As the flames engulfed my worldly possessions, my everything seemed to disappear. But I did not cry for the loss of money. I cried for the photographs and the poems and the amber beads. I love you, Mother. And I love the mother who died while I rested in your womb. My sister tells me stories of visiting grandma and eating pickles. And I can remember every spring, every Mother's Day, you would diligently plant flowers around the Bakuta's name. I've learned to love her without ever seeing her face. Joseph tells me that I seem like my mother, and I only pray to God that he's right. But then my existence would keep the love and the caring alive in a kind of living that no strike of a match, that no burning building, that no mere mortal could destroy. Childhood Memories, one in a series of poems. I'm just going to read the first one. Childhood Memories, one. I was in the basement, the playroom. That's where all my toys are, you see. And I had just run in there after yelling at my family sitting in the living room, I hate you. Now, I've never said that before to my family, nor would I ever say it again. I knew better. But I had just run into the playroom, slammed the door shut. I couldn't have been more than five. And I ran in and I looked for things to put in front of the door so they couldn't open it and find me. I took one of my play chairs from my little play set and I dragged it over to the door. And then I took that little schoolhouse for Fisher Price toys. The side opened up and had a little blackboard and everything. I took that little schoolhouse, put it on the chair, guarding the door, patiently obeying my orders. I was running around looking for anything else I could carry to that door when I heard the doorknob turn and my sister, with one arm, push all my toys away and open the door. I knew I had been defeated. This one's called Chances One. Yes, it's yes. You asked me before if there are only so many loves in your life, if there are only so many chances for love. And I said, yes. And I know you think that it's because of fate, or God, or religion, but I know that there are only so many chances to feel that bond. That there can only be so many people who perfectly fit you, who fit you like a glove, who wants what you want, who feels like I feel, who dreams what you dream. You ask me if there are only so many loves who dream what you dream. You ask me if there are only so many loves, and my answer is yes. Oh, yes. It's yes. Yeah.